Hello and welcome to our first lesson in English 8 for the third quarter. This is Propaganda Techniques and this is in line with Persuasion. Now before we delve into the techniques, let us first have the denotation or the dictionary meaning of the word propaganda. According to Merriam-Webster Dictionary, propaganda is an information, especially of a biased or misleading nature, used to promote or publicize a particular political cause or point of view. This is also applicable in advertisements. Propaganda is also referring to the use of communication techniques that are meant to influence or persuade an audience. When we speak of persuasion, we mean convincing powers. So we use propaganda in order to convince people. And that is also applicable in advertisements, just like what I told you earlier. The objective of most propaganda techniques is to make the audience, or maybe your listener or reader, to change his or her opinion about something or to believe in something else. So today, let us explore the different techniques in propaganda. We have glittering generalities, name-calling, transfer, bandwagon, fear, and bad logic. Now, if you have accomplished our worksheet number one, you should have an idea of what these techniques are. So we have the glittering generalities. Glittering generalities is the technique which we use in order to associate, okay, a person or anything, an idea perhaps, to a positive symbol. An example of this one is branding something. Branding a product or branding a person. It could be, well, this politician is pro-poor or pro-democracy or pro-family and pro-life. So something that is positive that is associated to a person, a product, or an idea. Now, if we apply that to perhaps products or probably establishments, let us say BDO, what is their tagline, right? Like, it appears like a glittering generality. So, BDO, they say, we find ways. And for SM malls, they say, we've got it all for you. So, that is something positive, like, we've got it all for you, or we find ways. So, the idea is, technically giving your product or your quality, no, the associated positive symbol. Now, the opposite of glittering generalities, well, I guess you get this right, name-calling. Name-calling is the association of a person or idea or probably a product to a rather negative symbol. That is why this is the opposite of glittering generalities. This is very much rampant, especially during campaigns, like election campaigns. Like, some people would brand a particular senator or candidate as a communist, perhaps, or a trapo, a traditional politician. And when products use this, let's say detergent, right? When products use name-calling, they often use brand X. So if you choose brand X is a bad brand. You choose us or you choose our brand because this is the best brand ever. So somehow they use glittering generalities there. But when we speak of name-calling, that is also the usage of brand X. Don't buy that brand. That's brand X. So somehow they put a negative symbol on their rival product or company. So hopefully this is clear to you. Up next, we have the next propaganda technique, which is transfer. Now, on the other hand, we have the word transfer or propaganda technique, which is transfer. It is referred to as a false connection. I'll explain this later. A false connection technique, this is a device that links the authority or prestige of something or probably someone well-respected and revered to something that the propagandist would like his or her target audience to accept. Now, listen to this. When we speak of transfer, the most common establishment of a transfer propaganda technique is the use of ambassadors or brand ambassadors or endorsers. Let's say the endorser of this particular fast food chain is, let's say, Ann Curtis. Okay, somehow there are a lot of girls and probably guys who respect and idolize Ann Curtis. So, whatever she endorses, you will use. Something like that. Or probably Chris Aquino. Chris Aquino has a lot of followers. So, if you are Chris Aquino's fan, so whatever she endorses, you will use. So, that is transfer. The respect and the love that you give to that particular endorser is somehow transferred to the product or brand that he or she is endorsing. So another example is a politician who speaks during a religious event in the hope that the people's support of the church gets transferred to him or her and gets translated into votes during an election. So I think that is also very familiar to you. Up next, we have the fourth. Is this a fourth? The fourth propaganda, which is fear. Okay? It uses the people's fear to move them to action or accept a belief. Okay, let me give you an example for this one. For example, an anti-smoking campaign that shows what happens to the body of one suffering from lung cancer due to smoking is a very good example of fear propaganda technique. Okay, so it moves you to do something because you fear of something to happen. So yeah, classic example is the anti-smoking campaign, which shows, you know, this is a normal lung and this is the lung of a smoker, and somehow I don't want to get that those lungs, so I better stop smoking, or I better quit, stop, or not smoke at all. So that is fear propaganda technique. Up next, we have bandwagon. So there is an idiom which is jump on the bandwagon or jump on the wagon. So somehow it gives you an idea that it tells you to follow the crowd. So this technique simply says indirectly that everyone else is doing it and so should you. So this technique capitalizes on people's desire to be in or to belong. So an example of this is an advertisement that says 9 out of 10 coffee drinkers have switched to drinking this new brand of coffee. So, oh my goodness, 9 out of 10. So, I better switch because I'm not yet part of the 9 out of 10. So, somehow, it capitalizes on your feeling to be in. Oh, I want to taste that coffee too. So, I better switch. Okay, so that's bandwagon. And last but not the least, we have bad logic. Now, understand this, bad logic. This is a propaganda technique, right? So, it doesn't matter whether this is bad logic. This is another example of common propaganda technique that plays on the reasoning of the audience. So, in this technique, logic is deliberately manipulated to persuade people for or against a cause. Again, bear in mind that you are being manipulated here, okay? And the manipulation, unfortunately, is bad logic, but even if it's bad, that's what I told you earlier. This is a persuasion, a persuasive tool. So, hear me out. For example, one online gamer got sick of cancer. Okay? Now, to say that an online game makes its player sick just because one player of the game was diagnosed with a cancer, it's illogical, right? Such a conclusion could not have been arrived at with just one known incident. But as a propagandist, using bad logic is like that, you know? You may claim that young people should not play games because online games cause cancer. Illogical, but bear in mind, you are convincing others. So, bad logic may work, okay? So, going back, we have talked about the six common propaganda techniques, which are littering generalities, name calling, transfer, bandwagon, fear, and bad logic.
That is all for our lesson on propaganda techniques. You may now proceed to your next activity. Thank you!